Yesterday we have studied about a baker from Goa. So what we have studied that what is the particular name for a baker from Goa? Padher. It is called as Padher. So when he is coming to sell the breads, when he is coming? Twice a day. Okay, twice in the morning and while coming to sell the breads and afterwards while going after selling the breads. Okay, so what kind of attitude does children have in order to get the breads? What children feel when Padher is coming to sell the breads? They were very excited. So what they were doing? They used to stand on the bench or climb the parapet in order to have a look in the basket of the Padher. Okay, and what they relish most? Sweet bread. And it is also called, it is in the form of bangles. Okay, it is in the form of bangles that they used to enjoy a lot, right? Okay, so what announces the oncoming of the bread seller or the baker? It was the jang jang sound. How this sound is produced? By the bamboo staff when it is thumped onto the ground. Okay. Now, let us study on page number is 86. I am reading from the paragraph, the baker made his musical entry. The baker made his musical entry on the scene with the jang jang sound of his specially made bamboo staff. This we have read yesterday. Okay. And one hand supported the basket on his head and the other banged the bamboo onto the ground. So how he is coming, he is holding a basket over his head. His one hand is supporting that basket and with the other hand he is thumping or he is putting that bamboo staff onto the ground to produce the sound. He would greet the lady of the house with good morning and then place his basket on the vertical bamboo. So when he enters the house, he greets the lady and put his basket onto that bamboo stick. Wickets would be pushed aside with the mild rebuke and the loaves would be delivered to the servant. But we would not give up. We would climb a bench or parapet and peep into the basket. So what it is said that the children, they used to climb the parapet as they are so curious to know. They know that there are breads, but they wanted to see for themselves only. And they would climb the parapet also to have a look into the basket of the baker. I can still recall the typical fragrance of those loaves. Loaves for the elders and bangles for the children. So what he said, the writer is saying that even he also want to have the fragrance, to have the smell of these loaves of bread, which is giving a fresh as well as inviting temptation to his senses. Loaves, piece of bread. Then we did not even care to brush our teeth or wash our mouths properly. And why should we? Who would take the trouble of plucking the mango leaf for the toothbrush? So then afterwards, what they were saying that they were not at all brushing their teeth also. Why they were not brushing their teeth also? Because they were feeling it not so, you can say, easy to pluck a mango leaf and brush the teeth. So then we did not even do it. And the tiger never brushed his teeth. Hot tea could wash and clean up everything so nicely after all. So ultimately he said that even tigers, they don't wash their faces before eating. So they themselves think that they are like tigers. Okay. So next afterwards. Marriage gifts are meaningless without the sweet bread known as bowl. So the special type of bread which is made during the marriage time, what it is called as? It is called as bowl. Please underline it. So the marriage ceremony is incomplete without these types of bread, just as a party or a feast loses its charms without bread. So if bread is not served and bread is not made during a party or any kind of feast or celebration, it is thought over to be wasted, or you can say useless. Not enough can be said to show how important a baker can be for a village. So it is not, you can say, it is not the undeniable fact that the baker is, of course, very important part of the village. He plays a very important role in the marriage ceremonies that are going to be held in the village. And moreover, he is also playing a great role in the village. The lady of the house must prepare sandwiches on the occasion of her daughter's engagement. So what the lady of the house is doing, she is preparing the sandwiches. Okay. So what is the ceremony that she used to prepare sandwiches on the occasion of her daughter's engagement? So when there is an engagement of the daughter, she used to make special type of sandwiches. And cakes and bolinas are a must for Christmas as well as other festivals. And during festival season, what special type of breads are available? Cakes and bolinas. Underline it, please. So many new names are there in this chapter. Thus, the presence of the baker's furnace in the village is absolutely essential. So what the writer is saying, that the presence of the baker is very, very much important in the village. Okay. So what importance does a bread hold in a village? Yes. Raise up your hands. Yes, Anshika. What importance does a bread hold or a baker holds in a village? So ultimately, sit down, please. Let me repeat also that the presence of the baker in the village is a great part of the tradition of the village, because during the marriage ceremony, the mother of the daughter, she used to make special type of sandwiches, and a special type of bread is also served during the marriage, which is called as bol. Okay. And during all the festivals in the village, like cakes as well as bolinas, they have been made. So no festival or no celebration is complete without the presence of the baker. So the baker or bread seller of those days had a peculiar dress known as kabai. So underline, Raghav, what are you doing, please? Turn your face, otherwise silence. So what does the baker or the bread seller of those days wear? Means there is a peculiar special type of dress is worn by the baker of those days, which is called as kabai, which is known as kabai. What it was actually? Has anybody seen it? Now that description will come, you will be able to understand. It was a single piece long frock reaching down the knees. Okay, so what is this kabai? It is a long frock worn even by men. Okay, which is reaching up to the knees. And in our childhood, we saw bakers wearing a shirt and trousers, which were shorter than full length ones and longer than half pants. Okay, so now the narrator is saying that when he was a young child, what they have seen a baker wearing, you can say, trousers and shirts, but their trousers are shorter than the pants. Okay, it means reaching till the knees only, right? Maybe because they are working with the, you can say, flour and dough, and ultimately in order to avoid the powdered form. Okay, and moreover, they are working in front of the furnace. Okay, so they wanted, because of much heat, they have adapted this kind of dress, right? So earlier it was kabai, then with the passage of time, transition took place. Na? For example, in actual Indian dress was something else, dhoti kurta. And gradually what happened, we have adopted another dresses. Okay, similarly, in every, you can say, form of dress, there is transition, or in every profession, there is transition. So this is what he is saying. And even today, anyone who wears a half pant and reaches just below the knees, it invites the comment that he is dressed like a padel. So now this is the common comment given to the person who is wearing a pant a bit lower than the trouser, that he is just looking like a pade. So these type of particular type of pants which are lower than the knees, what are they called as? They are called as kabai, which is worn by pade. The baker usually collected the bills at the end of the month. So finally, he is not collecting the money daily. Okay. So how the bills are collected? He is collecting all the money by the end of the month. Monthly accounts, they used to be recorded on some wall in pencil. So how he is noting down the monthly accounts? Not in a diary on a piece of paper, but on the walls, for example, behind the door. He is noting down for today 2 breads, 3 breads, 4 breads, 5 bangles in this manner. He is noting down all the account and he is putting in there. And baking was indeed a profitable profession in the old days. So in the old days, this was quite flourishing and profitable profession. And the baker and his family never starved. And this has never happened that the baker and his family has ever starved, because this business was quite flourishing. It was quite developing. And you know the business which is accountable to meet the needs of each and every house. Okay. It is always flourishing. Why? Because individual needs, they are more, okay, than the needs of a group. So it is the individual need to have bread and to eat bread. So this is the reason why they have a flourishing business at that time. Okay. So he and his family has and his servants always looked happy and prosperous, because it was very much prosperous business, flourishing business in the old days. So all the people, whether they are the main bakers or their servants, they are always happy and prosperous, making good money. Their plump physique was an open testimony. Testimony means proof to this. And their plump figures, that they are rounded and plump figures, this represents their, you can say, prosperous nature. So even today, any person with a jackfruit like physical appearance is easily compared to a baker. Jackfruit, which is round one. Okay, if a person is having this kind of appearance, he is always compared to that of a baker. Okay, and he is often called as pade. So this is the first account which we have read here, okay, from Glimpses of India. Okay, so let us revise at once before we start the question answers. So first of all, what this chapter is about? The chapter is about a baker from Goa. Okay, so baker from Goa, from where they have its origin? Portuguese origin, it is mentioned in the starting. Okay, yes, really, yes. We are not living in Goa. This is the reason why we are not able to identify with them. Those people who are from Goa, they must have seen. For example, you know, every state has its own culture. The chapter is Glimpses of India. It means that they are going to give a just glimpse of 3 different states, Assam, Coorg, and this Goa. Okay, so with this we come to know that these bakers, they really exist. Okay, why did the narrator said the persons who prepared the breads were no longer exist? Okay, the persons who eat bread no longer exist, but the persons who makes it exists. Yes, because of transformation or passage or transformation of the business, of the family business, from one generation to the next one. Okay, so yes. First 2 pages, okay, listen to me. So baker from Goa, first of all, the narrator is saying that their elders, they are always deep-heartedly, they were remembering those old Portuguese days. Why? Because when they were lovers of bread, people love to eat bread. Okay, and those eaters of bread, he said that they have vanished. but those bakers, they still exist. Why he said so? It is because of the reason of the transformation of the transformation of the business from one generation to the next one. Those bread eaters may have died, but those actually bakers, they still exist in one or the other form. Okay, so where they have made the breads in special kind of furnaces. Okay, they were making the bread. Okay, so what announces the oncoming of the bread maker or the baker? It is the jing-jang sound of the bamboo staff that he made with the, that he, you can say that he stabs onto the ground, or with that he makes a thud onto the ground. Silence, please. Right? And there is a special name given to the baker in Goa. What it is named as? It is named as Padev. Okay? So, in his childhood, the narrator, he has explained about his childhood experience. So, what he has said that in his childhood, the baker used to be their friend, companion, as well as guide. Okay? So, how many times he is coming? He is coming twice a day. One time when he is coming to sell his breads, and the second time while he is going after emptying his huge basket. Okay? And this I have told you, that the jingling thud of the bamboo stick, it, you can say, marks its presence, or it announces its coming. Okay? Who is purchasing those loaves of bread? The maid servant, which is called as Pestine. They are purchasing those breads. And when he comes to the house, he makes a musical entry. Then what he used to do, he takes his, you can say, basket off the head and settles it up onto a bamboo stick. And ultimately, he greets the lady of the family and give the breads, okay, to the people. And then he has also explained about the behavior of the kids. Behavior of the kids is clear, Kanishka? So what kind of behavior is shown by the kids when Padev is coming? They were very much excited. What they want? Bengal-shaped breads they want, and sometimes they overlook their daily routine. Also, for example, brushing their teeth, they were so excited to eat those pieces of bread. Okay, loaves of bread. So next, afterwards, we have read about that the making of bread is an important part of the every marriage ceremony. Why? Because the mother of the daughter, she used to make sandwiches. Okay, and special type of bread which is known as bol, which is a sweet bread. It is a feast for all the invitees over there, right? And moreover, after that, cakes and bulinas. These are also special type of breads that form the part of every celebration or festivity, right? So what kind of dress those padesh they were wearing? Kabai. This is known as kabai. What actually a kabai is? It is a long frock reaching up to the knees, or below, somewhat below the knees. Okay? And but later on, the narrator has also mentioned that they were also wearing shirts and trousers. Good. Shirts and trousers they were wearing, but their trousers were longer ones? No. It was reaching, they were half pants below the knees. Okay? Then afterwards, he said that if any person, they would see any person wearing these kind of trousers, they would usually be called as padev. Okay? And what kind of business it was in the older times? It was quite flourishing business. People used to flourish. They used to earn a lot of money with that business. And because of this, all the people who were involved in this type of baking business, whether they will be, you can say, the main bakers, their servants, they all were prosperous. What is the depiction of their prosperous life? Their plum physique is the depiction of their prosperous life. Okay? And if any person, what comparison he has made? That if any person is having jackfruit-like appearance, then what he is often called as? Padev. Right? So that's all for this chapter. Tomorrow we will discuss the question answers of this chapter. Okay. And now if you have any doubt, you can ask me.